our town, like so many others, is grey and dull at times, and we wanted to bring colour to the streets. The ethos that sits behind the project is artists for everyone. We wanted to bring art to people that may not go to galleries because they feel intimidated, and instead the community can step straight out of their front doors and into an open-air gallery.
So the first round of Colour in Romford was funded by Havering Council and the GLA. It was an open competition that we put out for local artists to put in their work to create murals. So the four that we chose out of that competition were Grant Pearce's Monkey Does, Loughborough Point Revisited by Chris Stevens, The Reader by Annika Manuel, and New Forest by Brennan and Birch.
The second phase of Colour in Romford came about through the absolute positive reaction we saw from the public and the residents of Romford. It seemed such a shame just to leave it there with four murals, and with our dream of like having this painted town, it seemed the best step to go forward and get more art on our streets.
So for phase two of Colour in Romford, we have a new set of artists on board who can all bring their new personal style to the project. So Art and Believe are a Brighton-based duo who have travelled the world to produce beautiful murals, mainly working with the local community. And Art and Believe will be producing the retailery mural.
I suppose an absolute highlight has been watching Art and Believe put up the mural on the retailery. The retailery is a project close to our hearts anyway, and to see it getting even better with this fantastic, bright, graphic print really brought a smile to my face.
Desire is a Belgian-based artist. We had him flown over to produce the mural for the brewery. The notion of the peregrine falcon is that a peregrine falcon used to frequent the vicinity of the brewery at some point, so it's a kind of a nod towards that reference. Desire has a really, really beautiful style. It's very, very illustrative and very much to do with nature, and we think that it really complements that space very well.
We got approached by the artist while he was doing the falcon. He would be leaving at sort of between 3 and 4 o'clock every morning. He'd be doing the work overnight on the falcon, and every night when he left, he saw a town fox wandering around the brewery.
I think my inspiration for this wall is that I worked at the brewery every night, and we saw every night we saw the fox coming in, searching for food, finding his way and then disappear again. So I want to give this wall a tribute to the fox that I saw every night. So that's the story behind this wall. Yeah.
Ben Eine is a world-renowned street artist. If you're not familiar with his name, I'm sure you've definitely seen some of his famous typography. One of the famous stories is that David Cameron gave Barack Obama one of Ben Eine's artwork, and that was hung in the White House. So we're super, super pleased to have him in Romford.
The first official state visit between David Cameron and President Obama. They exchanged paintings, and my painting was the painting that David Cameron chose to give to Obama.
Madness. So it hung in the White House for a while?
It hung in one of Obama's daughter's bedrooms for 8 years.
Oh my gosh.
And I'm sure it's now in a bonfire with the rest of the stuff that Donald Trump hates.
When I first discussed the mural with Ben, we tried to come up with different ideas as to what would go on there, what would the text be. And we had this wonderful idea whereby a band called Underworld, who'd created the song Born Slippy, which was used in Trainspotting. It references going back to Romford, because there was a time when Underworld did live here. So we contacted Underworld, and they very kindly allowed us to use four of their lyrics. We asked the public on Facebook to see what everyone would like to see on the Romford mural, and that's what stands on fiction now. That's our mural. I think it's a really, really nice nod to all of the cultural heritage that we have in Romford.
To do something in Romford that's like spiritually Romford, and then to have the band that I've never met come back and go, "This is amazing." It's like, yeah.
It's proper cool, isn't it?
Yeah, it's really cool.
Alongside the mural, Ben delivered a really wonderful workshop for students of Redbridge College in the retailery. He delivered a wonderful, wonderful artist talk where he explained that he originally started off graffitiing walls, and then further on in his career, he ended up doing a collaboration with Louis Vuitton. He explained how he bridged that gap and all these steps that he took, and it was really inspirational. We had such wonderful feedback from the students. Because it's a way of saying that art is for everyone. Everyone can aspire to be an artist, and it's achievable for everyone. It's excellent for us to be able to reinforce that with world-renowned artists that have just proved that point very well.
To have the opportunity to come here and do something that people are either going to ignore or love, or there'll be some little kid that goes, "That's the most inspiring thing I've ever seen. I need to learn about this. I need to find out about it. And in 20 years' time, I want to be the kid that does that."
I would absolutely love to have mural workshops whereby local students work alongside famous artists to produce the artwork. So students would be able to say, I helped create, you know, the mural that's been on the wall for say 50 years, and look back on that and think, wow, I had a part of that. And that's the aim for to have as much community involvement as possible, really.
For the future of colour in Romford, we genuinely want to create a painted town. We've made a great start, but we've got so many walls we've got our eyes on.